Welcome to Health Talk. This is your host and dost, Dr. Ashish Chauhan, consultant Apollo Preventive Medicine. I've heard of late, everything has become complicated when it comes to ladies. I know the ladies out here will not like to hear it, but everybody's talking about menstrual problems, then they find it tough to get a baby or conceive, and then they find it tough that the delivery is an issue. So is it all about commercialization of the medicine, or there is something genuine into it which we need to know? And to discuss the same, with us we have today Dr. Manjula Anagani. Ma'am is a graduate and postgraduate from Hyderabad Gandhi Medical College as well as Usmania Medical College, a Padma Shri from 2015, as well as practicing in Hyderabad from last 22 years. Welcome, ma'am.
Good morning.
How do you believe that, is the statement true that things have become complicated when it comes to gynecological problems? What's your take on it?
Dr. Ashish, I think the statement is true as far as everything, anything in life is concerned. Everything has, the relationships have become complicated, the way we look at life has become complicated, and our lifestyle is the thing which is to be blamed for most of the problems which we have today. See, the way we see the kids who are couch potatoes, we don't see them who are exercising, who are doing plays today.
Yeah.
Everybody is on their phones, on the televisions, and then there's hardly time between the relationships which are developing between the parents and the kids and everything. So saying that, when I say lifestyle, basically just this obesity which has personified in the recent times, plus the environmental hazards, we all talk about this green zone and we talk about ozone layer going thing and everything. So what is happening with all these things is we are getting exposed to a lot of these pollutants.
Mm-hmm.
We all know the vegetables which we eat is not the same. The apples which we eat are all having wags. Or even if you get the vegetables, they say if it's from the Musi River, it is full of iodine and all those things.
Yes.
So when we are looking at all these pollutants, they will not just leave us. Right.
Mm-hmm.
So they're going to affect us in many ways. When we are talking of increased cancers and we are talking about increased thyroid, like, you know, like any doctor can say, the endocrinology, the whole system is in a very sensitive network.
Mm-hmm.
It's all the networking which matters when it comes to the body. There's a fine network between the brain and any organ which functions.
Yes.
So in gynecology per se, it is between the brain and the ovaries and the uterus.
Mm-hmm.
This is what is called the hypothalamo-pituitary-ovarian axis.
Mm-hmm.
So any stress,
mm-hmm.
anything we undergo, because
mm-hmm.
of what we spoke about, the strained relationships, everything,
and
environmental things. Diogenes, which are increasing because of plastics usage,
yeah.
and the government talks about how we have to abandon that. There is truth in that,
mm-hmm.
especially the sanitary napkins, which has plastics in it, which is exposed to the gynecological organs.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of exposure to the diogenes.
Okay.
The whole hormonal status changes.
Okay.
Women are becoming more masculine. When I say that, it
yeah.
is not just in the thought processes about what we want to achieve. It is basically because of the hormones which are changing, more increased androgen and less estrogen and progesterone.
Mm-hmm.
So same thing happens. Stress combined with these pollutants together is leading to increased incidence of thyroid disorders,
mm-hmm.
increased incidence of PCOS, which every 1 in 3 women in India right
now
is
happening. I remember almost in our graduation days, almost 2-3 decade back in CMC Vellore, we never heard what is PCOS, and right now I hear PCOS clinic, and every lady seems to be having it.
Every girl,
so,
there's no age, Chauhan, which is deplete of it, right from 12-13 years to 55 years.
Because I believe a lot of our viewers probably will not know,
yes.
what is this PCOS,
see,
and what is kind of effect they
yeah,
have?
When I say PCOS, it is not a disease, it is a polycystic ovarian syndrome.
Mm-hmm.
When I say syndrome, it is very, very, like a huge gamut of the organs, everything is getting affected by
mm-hmm.
it. Why did it start and why are we looking at it? You do not see a young girl who is playing on the ground or somebody who is like bindas will never have PCOS. It is our kids who are in this thing, wherein in this rat race of writing, studying for exams, and lot of stress about preparing for MCATs, preparing for IITs and all those things.
Mm-hmm.
This stress will affect the adrenal organs.
Okay.
Adrenals will have a direct linkage again with the ovary.
Mm-hmm.
So there is an increased DHEAS
mm-hmm.
and testosterone.
Mm-hmm.
See, when I literally said the women are becoming more masculine, what's happening is this testosterone which is increasing
mm-hmm.
will cause abnormal hair
mm-hmm.
and will cause irregular periods
mm-hmm.
and ovulation is not happening.
Okay.
And because of this, again, locally, there is increased estrogen and decreased progesterone, mm-hmm. and insulin resistance develops.
Yes.
So,
yes.
overall picture, what's happening, this young girl who's supposed to be very happy-go-lucky girl, pretty, enjoying life in that age group, is sitting as a couch potato, sitting and reading books and studying, stressed out,
no time
going
to.
Into depression, mm-hmm. and then abnormal hair everywhere, acne everywhere, obesity, mm-hmm. and irregular periods, once in 6 months or only when they take period, this thing. And later, we are neglecting this, not worried, because most of the thing very funny is parents come to me and tell me that my daughter is studying from morning 6:30 to evening 7-8. By the time they come home, it is so difficult. They study so well. They don't have time for exercise. Mm. But you're not understanding, this is the lifestyle disease. This is not a disease, mm-hmm. which can be just treated with medicines.
Okay.
So you don't do exercise. It's a vicious cycle which continues. You become obese, insulin resistance, and then again you don't do exercise, again insulin resistance. And so where are we breaking it?
Yeah.
Your junk food which you are eating, which is adding to the increased weight. Mm. So all this, later when they want to get married, mm-hmm. they're first out of shape and acne. So mm. they go into something trimming, whatever, giving lots to the market which is there, booming there. Mm. And then when they become pregnant, do they become pregnant? Because mm. they're not ovulating. We all know that you want a pregnancy and egg is necessary.
Mm-hmm.
So they're running around for infertility clinics, so that do they become pregnant. And because of this hormonal milieu, which is not good, okay. when they become pregnant, they have more abortions too. Oh. So with all these things, even in spite of all that is over, together, chodo. Agar 30, 40 years tak bhi aaya, kabhi bhi aasak, this can come any time in the life. Oh. Anytime stress comes, this can come back.
Okay.
So whatever happens, this will lead to metabolic syndrome. Mm-hmm. Means hypertension.
Yes.
Diabetes, mm-hmm. heart disease, mm-hmm. and these are all only in the middle.
Yes.
So first we have this gynecological problems. Mm-hmm. Later you have all this metabolic syndrome. Mm. If you still neglect PCOS, mm-hmm. they're going to end up with endometrial cancers, ovarian cancers. Mm. So it's not going to leave us if we don't know how to manage this problem.
Okay.
This has increased in the recent times. Mm-hmm. So whether we agree or not, these are the diseases which we have invited into our lives because of the things which we do not know. So this is PCOS, which has increased, like I said. But another disease which is terrifying and it is increasing is endometriosis, Dr. Ashish.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very fancy word, endometriosis. People might not be very easy to understand.
That's what I would want you to just explain to my viewers is what is endometriosis?
Rather than endometriosis, I think people will understand when we say, how does it present?
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time, previously, people know that when the periods come, one day they'll have this pain. Mm-hmm. You take some painkiller or rest for one day, they're fine.
Mm-hmm.
But now, these people, these kids or even adult women, first thing is they will have pain right from 3-4 days before the menstrual cycle comes.
Okay.
It is like congestion mm-hmm. in the roads of Hyderabad,
yes.
how it happens.
Mm-hmm.
The same way the whole uterus, everything gets congested because of the disease which is there.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that disease, because of the congestion, they'll have excruciating pain. It's the most debilitating disease a woman can have.
Mm-hmm.
PCOS does not cause pain. It will
yeah.
cause other problems.
Mm-hmm.
But in endometriosis, your life is crucified because mm-hmm. it's going to cause terrible pain throughout the periods,
mm-hmm.
till the end of the periods. It is not just that. It completely destroys the local tissues. It's
mm-hmm.
a locally invasive disease.
Mm-hmm.
It is, in simple words, it is like cancer but not cancer.
Okay.
It goes on invading locally.
Mm-hmm.
Anatomy is completely destroyed.
Mm-hmm.
Again, infertility because they do not conceive because of this. And abortion rates are very, very high. And let me tell you one thing. If you go for IVF too,
yeah.
your IVF results are very bad even with endometriosis.
Okay.
So it's that bad a disease. And many times people come and say they'll be suffering so much. They will come and say, please remove my uterus and all. People don't
okay.
understand is even at 25, even if you get your uterus removed, the disease can come back.
Mm-hmm.
So it is not just the removal of the uterus and ovaries which is going to sort out this problem.
Mm-hmm.
It is again, to start off, it is again a lifestyle disease. Unfortunately, there is another topic which is something which I want to touch, Dr. Ashish, that is, why is this estrogen increasing in the thing? These are the diseases of, again, when I say high estrogen states in the woman.
Mm-hmm.
Endometriosis, fibroids which are increasing, they're all because of increased estrogen.
Mm-hmm.
From where are we getting this increased estrogen? Is it mm-hmm. only the junk food which we are eating?
Mm-hmm.
What we have to understand is, whatever we eat outside, let me take the names, I don't know if I'll have to, but Kentucky chicken or that chicken, this chicken, mm. people eat. From where is that chicken? How is it becoming such huge chicken?
Okay.
So people try to adulterate. We all know we are eating adulterated food.
Oh, yes.
But what adulteration? Is it oxytocins which are being given so that the weight increases in that?
Yes.
So because of oxytocin, you have prolactin, everything going awry. So there will be progesterone decrease and increased estrogen. Mm-hmm. Or direct estrogen to these cows so that extra milk can come or whatever. Yes. Or estrogen causing hyperplasia of the tissues so that the chicken becomes more heavy. Mm. See, for a person who is selling chicken to me, for them it is their benefit which is important. Mm. So they want a chicken to weigh 1.5 kg or 2 kg or whatever. So he will use whatever it is without even thinking beyond a point that I am doing harm to the society.
Mm.
See, in his brain, he is not looking at harm to the society. Mm. For him, I am getting the gain of extra money.
Yeah.
But people, whatever you do, you boil it or whatever, estrogen is not going to go. It's a hormone. Mm. Which is adherent to the tissue. So you are eating it, so your increased this thing is there in the body. This increased estrogen is an exogenous estrogen. Mm. Means your ovaries are producing some amount of estrogen, but from outside you are taking estrogen. So that's doing the damage.
You know what, as an internal medicine specialist, rather you are telling me something which I never thought about it.
Yeah.
Probably that's the reason now males are more feministic.
Feminine.
You know?
And did you see that increased incidence of gynecomastia?
Oh, yes.
So that is again because of this chicken and the milk. Mm. Most of the time, very funny, Dr. Ashish, is when people, government is giving us this pasteurized milk, people still believe getting the cows to home and then taking milk is good. Mm. But again, the cows or the whatever buffalo is coming is also adulterated. They are being given the injections to give more milk. Mm. That milk, how much ever you boil, is still full of the hormones. So I have seen a 4-month-old kid with breast development.
Oops.
4 months.
Months old. Can you believe that?
And 11-year-old kid, boy, thinking of not even going out and not going for swimming because he has breasts.
Mm.
All this is again because of adulteration of the food which we are getting. First, that is adulteration. When we are talking about food and all, it is much more easy for us to talk about adulterated food, milk, etc. But it is very difficult for us to talk about the sanitary napkins and the plastics which when exposed to the uterine lining.
Mm-hmm.
What happens is this, when you get exposed, the receptivity of the progesterone is gone. So the opposite happens, means increased estrogen. So endometriosis will be more, endometrial cancers will be more, infection rates will be there. So you have to use, you have to avoid using this plastic sanitary napkins and start using organic ones or something which has bleached cotton or something like that, rayon. So saying that, we are not telling them to use a cloth and all, that's not again not safe. But use something which does not have a plastic inside.
Okay.
That is what we are talking about.
Just to interrupt you here is, how do a general population know, say so many brands are there.
Yes.
And they just go and they ask for one particular brand and take
it. Yeah,
so
that's what, one thing you have to know is, please use something which is very clearly written that there is no plastic inside, or there are so many, quite 2-3 brands which are available, not Mariban. But you can go online and then in there are organic sanitary napkins.
Mm-hmm.
See, when we were doing one of the interview, one of the thing for one of the radio, I got a call from US where that lady was from there telling that I am taking only organic milk, I'm not taking other milk or any other milk. So is it safe? I am like, you know, the awareness of this organic thing, even in the milk, because of the increased hormone status, is something which is increasing worldwide.
Mm.
I think this awareness is something which we need to spread to our population that, yes, adulterated food is a norm. Don't take it that they're also taking, I'm also taking. So, but try to save our next generation from it.
I know, that's something
so
very important.
So spread the thing that, yes, these are the pollutants. Try to avoid using plastics and plastic fumes which we are getting exposed, and the poultry and the fish which we are getting.
Mm.
So you know, if you go into villages, you do know all these ponds of prawns and all which are going to come are all adulterated with the seed which they are giving to them.
Mm-hmm.
So I think this is something which a government has to take it in a bigger way, see that the adulteration does not go to it beyond a level.
I know. So things are really seen. I do not know how right is this data. They say apparently the need of the milk requirement in India is 14 lakh barrels.
Right.
Okay. And is what is getting produced, but we are using 50 lakh.
That's what I'm saying. From where is this
coming
from?
So where is this 36 is coming from?
So that is all being adulterated.
The YouTube is full where they make milk out of shampoo.
Yes.
So now I'm scared of seeing the milk because most of the times, by avoiding milk, most of my patients are feeling much better.
Yeah.
So all this GI upset, they have okay.
It's all intolerance because of the adulteration.
Yes.
That's why I keep telling, why are you worried about taking the pasteurized milk, which a government or whichever so-called this thing grabs? Don't try to think that the other one which you are going to get
is a better one.
It's not. It might be more adulterated.
Remember that.
And when we are talking about pollution, Dr. Ashish, we are talking about the number of vehicles increased.
Oops,
tell me that.
Too much. The back fires
and the carbon monoxide.
I'm very happy that you brought this up, because I would want to tell to all the viewers, a lot of people come to me, sir, I don't want to take statin.
Yeah.
Why should I take medicine?
True.
I'm absolutely fine. And when I'm fine, why should I take the medicine? So I've told, and I would want to communicate, if you do not want to take any medicine, the only place you should stay is Himalayas.
Yes.
Because that's only place where you get the pure water,
oxygen,
pure air, and no stress.
Yes.
And you have to be
and
single.
Oxygen.
And you've got to be single to make sure you have
stress
a stressless life.
Continuation of that, Dr. Ashish, when you said people don't want to take medicine, there are so many times, so many myths about women and hormonal treatment.
Yeah.
I want to break it now. Mm-hmm. See, what happens, people say, we don't want to take hormones. Hormones are bad.
Yeah.
And, you know, my grandmother said, if I take hormones, I'll put on weight.
Mm.
You know, somebody so-and-so said, took hormones and they had acne. These are all the myths. What we have to understand are, a human being is not alive without hormones.
Without hormones, true.
Hormones are most essential thing in the body.
Mm.
It can be estrogen, it can be progesterone, it can be androgen for libido, it can be thyroid, it can be
insulin.
Every body, the adrenaline rush we talk about, people go and jump out of mountains thinking that adrenaline rush will give them high.
Mm.
Why are you talking about the hormones? They're also hormones.
Mm.
We are born to have a balance in our life. We are not born to have an imbalance in our life.
Mm.
Means imbalance is not a norm.
Mm.
So if your body is having a high estrogen and less progesterone, please get it back to normal. How is it possible? I cannot decrease the estrogen which is being produced in your body. So I better give you something which can combat that by giving in the form of other opposite hormone in the form of a tablet from outside. Otherwise, unopposed estrogen can lead to cancers in the body. This is something you have to understand.
Mm.
And the balance, like I said, will not cause overweight or acne. If it's you're overusing it, or like I always say, people always tend to overuse anything without prescriptions, without the need, that's when you end up having complications. And remember, science has progressed. We are not lying down in the first generation of OC pills. Now we have fourth generation OC pills where the tablets are just enough for you not to become pregnant if you don't want to become pregnant. See, the side effects are so-called side effects of OC pills are negligible or hardly seen. But definitely side effects of abortions are real. You end up having an abortion, you become pregnant and say, we don't want now, we want an abortion. Then yes, death can happen on table also. So that is a real, this is a myth or a fancy.
I'm very happy Dr. Manjula has talked about the need for drugs. I would want to tell a few things as a practicing clinician. Drugs are poison, you are right to understand that, and that balance only one person can make it, and that is what doctor is there for.
Yes.
Please do not go to a chemist and ask him to decide the dose. This is high power medicine, this is low power medicine. I have had a lot of patients coming to me, give me 5 milligrams of amlodipin instead of 40 milligrams of telmisartan, because 5 milligrams is lower than 40 milligrams.
Sounds less.
That's a wrong calculation.
Yeah.
All these things is what a doctor is qualified to help you with. Less dose of tablet will harm you. More dose of tablet will harm you. And the right doses or optimum dose is what is required. And that is what your doctor is there to help you out. I would like to reiterate answer and the mnemonic or the stuff which I keep communicating to you is, go to a doctor when you do not need him and you will never need him.
Right.
You are only going to reach late to a
prevention
doctor, which will complicate a situation. Right now, I'm going to ask Dr. Manjula, of late, we have so many sudden increase of infertility.
True.
Everybody is talking about it. In infertility centers, there is a huge line
rush.
And the rush. What is that all about? And is it only a lady to be blamed for? Or is it men are more feminine? I would be very happy to hear anything from
that. Let me put
it
in another perspective, opposite side of it. Yeah, but WHO long back has told that 1/3 of the reason for infertility is a woman, 1/3 is because of man, and 1/3 is because both of them. That
okay.
holds true even today.
Mm-hmm.
In olden times, what used to happen is, when we were doing our medicine, 80 million of semen analysis supposed to be normal, anything less is subfertile.
Yeah,
okay, I will not
yeah.
say infertile.
Mm.
So then what happened is, it has come down to 40 million by the time I was doing PG.
Uh-huh.
Now, even 10 million is normal. Means our standards have come down so low because of the environmental hazard and the semen analysis coming down. So when we say that, then we are living in a subfertile world. Yes. Leaving that aside, like we said, we are having so many diseases which have increased, which is directly proportionate to the infertility rates like that. But there is also, when I say femininity of man has increased, masculinity of woman has increased, that means the career orientation, the way we look at life, your financial independence of the woman, everything has increased. So they want to, the marriage time date has increased nowadays.
Yes.
So they get married when they're 26, 28, then they want to understand each other. So by the time they think of pregnancy, it is 30, 29, 30. Unfortunately, because of pollution, the biological clock is ticking and we are having a premature menopause too. Then the stress, superadded stress adds, family pressure adds, and very funnily, they don't have time for each other.
Yeah,
one person is doing day duty, one person is doing night duty, and they're like, doctor, can you just do IUIs because people want me to become pregnant? They don't have time for family life.
I know.
They don't understand. So these are all the coexisting factors which have increased in the recent time. So, but when we divide basically medically, if I want to divide, it is always five basic factors in woman or the man. One from the brain. That is the most important thing. Your stress or your hormonal imbalance in the brain, that has a direct proportion to the ovary.
Okay.
So second is at the ovary level. You're not ovulating or you're again having a bad thing, PCOS or any ovarian cysts or endometrioma or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
Or the signals between the brain and the ovary is not good. Third is the fallopian tube. Uterus, the tube through which the egg comes or the sperm goes and the baby forms.
Yeah.
And then it goes into the uterus.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a blocked or diseased, ectopics, everything. Then you have uterus per se, where if you have fibroids, if you have a cavity problem, infections, again, because of your abortion before you had the cavity which is stuck together. So all these things plus. Finally, the cervical level. At that level, if you have an antibody against the sperms or anything or infection again, that will not cause. So on the top of it will always the brain and your resistance to it and your stress level you are undergoing.
Mm.
So these are the five segments on which we divide usually for a woman.
Okay.
And the same thing applies for the man too.
Mm-hmm.
It's again the stress, where he works, how he works, the amount of stress at the job, at the home and everything in the brain level and the hormones.
Mm-hmm.
Then again, testicular hormones and the production of the sperm and all. Then the storage level at epididymis, how it is. Then along the spermatic cord, if there is any block or anything. And finally, the environment around, that is varicose seals or anything, any hernias or anything which can increase the temperature so that the sperms which are produced are dying. So all the motility itself. Saying all this, in a continuation, I just want to make one point, Dr. Ashish, which is very important for people. Please understand the difference between supplements, medicines, medication, and the replacements. Supplements are, if your body has a deficiency of something like, you know, vitamins or anything, then that they are supplements. They are needed for the regular functioning of your body. Second, replacements is your body is supposed to produce something. It is not producing an adequate amount. If you don't take it, your functioning is going to be off-rail. That is replacement, like thyroid, like insulin, diabetes, the same way with the hormones in the ovary. Third category will be medication, means you have a disease and you're taking a medicine. That is when the doctor comes in. Remember that. Rest of the things, because why am I insisting on it is most of the time patients come and ask me, should I take it lifelong? Or if I take once, I'll get used to it, I believe. I have to take it long time, I believe. No. You understand, any production God has made, given us to do is produces, and that works only for one day. We eat three times a day because after 8 hours, we cannot live without eating. The same way this production has to happen every 24 hours. If it's not producing, we have to give it from outside. Sorry, we're changing the topic, but I thought this is something which people have
I'm very happy because whenever I started any patient on thyroid, oh sir, can we start to
stop it?
Can we stop it? Can we wait for one more month? I'm gonna say you will not work normally. See, I would be very happy to bring it out. Hair loss, the
everything.
Obesity, everything is attached with the thyroid.
Ovulation.
And they want to deal with
infertility, everything. And you know, worst part is abortion rates increases and the mental abnormality of the baby. If they are hypothyroid and you don't correct it in pregnancy, we want it to be less than 2.5.
Mm.
And you don't correct it and they become pregnant, the baby can be mentally abnormal also.
Mm-hmm.
Please remember that.
Mm-hmm.
All these things are very, very essential.
And with all these things, they will have a lot of emotional
turmoil.
So
absolutely.
That definitely affects, I mean, say we have too many marriages breaking very fast. I think the era has come. So how does a woman tackle
other
that?
Other than that, I'm more, again, this thing to a good you ask this question is a 12-year-old, 13-year-old coming and saying depression. I am like, what does a 13-year-old got to do with depression? Yesterday, when 16-year-old came, mother came, she's a history of depression on treatment. They're already on treatment for depression. Mm. OMG, what depression is this are we talking about? Mm. So them getting exposed to this level of stress they're undergoing because of education, the pressure of the stress. Mm. And we think of those malingering is they come back with again. When we were kids, we used to read about Tom Sawyer and pain abdomen or pain in the tooth. The same thing is repeating again. They come every month with pain in the abdomen to avoid the school, to avoid this. And they are like, because most of the time, again, in the recent time, we have seen deficiencies of vitamin D, vitamin B12, which can again directly be proportionate to increased incidence of depressions and PCOS. PCOS itself can cause depression. PCOS itself will have the body image change, body shaming, and they can have depression because they have this abnormal hair. They have darkness in the neck, everything. So all these things are something which we have
so
to understand.
So probably some kind of bonding between mother and daughter
is very essential.
Between your daughter and father and the whole family being together.
The stress, expectations of the society, expectations of the family, expectations of yourself on you. The point I'm saying is I've always been first in class. I'm scared whether I will lose this time, whether with this type of stress. And later when you're getting married, again, expectation of being a super mom, super wife, super everything kids. super is acting on it. And then if they become into OCD, Obsessive compulsive disorder. So for everything they start cleaning, doing it, that leads to an irritating point that yes, the stress level between the human beings and the way they behave outside is completely different. The minute they come home, there is a tension.
I know nowadays even what you told is please do an IUI. So everything has become mechanical.
Materialistic and mechanical.
You want to have a sex only to make sure that the person gets pregnant.
That's
otherwise, they are
not interested
in each other.
Yeah. So the sexual health itself has gone down the docks.
Yeah, yeah, very much.
They have to understand that there are so many studies which say that in the convalescent period, whenever the sexual health is good, that's when the dopamine and everything is, serotonin are going to be released. And they help in the healing of the tissues.
See, I do the master health checkup in corporate hospitals. And I have had, because this, most of the doctors don't talk about it.
It's a taboo in India.
It's a taboo in India. So, and I first thing I ask is, okay, how is your sex life? And then I have had a, you know, really weird and really scary answers. Once in a year. So I said, okay, are you both normal? I'm saying there's something wrong with you.
They think it is normal. And once in a year, how are you going to get pregnant?
That's the biggest problem. So,
and husband in some other city and they're here.
So the concept of family is what is important. And today's women, I think, everybody has a responsibility to address. And women need to handle that very well. But I must tell you, Dr. Manjula, you have fantastically covered almost everything which I think today's woman is fighting.
Right.
And I believe a lot of my viewers will be helped with this discussion and they will reach you.
I think underlining statement should be, everything comes in life, everything goes in life, but stress is something which we do not need. And positive stress and negative stress are a thing which we have to understand. If you take it as a positive stress, everything is good. We can master ourselves. But negative stress, when it starts affecting the body, is not good for life. So please avoid the pollution, avoid eating the adulterated food. Bindas, one last tip I want to give you. All of you don't have time for exercise, fine, okay. But you all have time for the exercising and everything in a simple way. You don't have to do skipping gym and everything. What you can do is, if you are in Rajnikant or Salman Khan, go into your room, close your room, put the bolt, 3 Tapori songs, bindas dance or thing, that is good
best
for
exercise.
Your muscles and aerobic exercises, that is good enough to get back your hormones into back. So please do that, avoid eating junk food, start playing outside again, stop seeing TV too much, and that will make your health much more healthier.
Fantastic. I think we've had a wonderful discussion with Dr. Manjula, and it will be nice to understand. So women have a lot of issues, and that is what we are here to discuss. I'd like to give this mnemonic of WOMEN, and that is what we are going to work it out. Today's woman, W is for worry. So she has a lot of things to worry about, and worship is an answer. And that's what we need to know, because succumbing to our Creator is something which helps out. We need to learn as well as teach and be together for the worshipping our Almighty. O is for obesity. Obesity is taking up because of a lot of junk food as well as over unnecessarily eating. We need to make sure that our obesity is within control. M is for menstrual irregularities, problems, and yes, that needs to be addressed with increased ratios of PCOS as well as endometriosis. So reach out to your doctor, your gynecologist who's near to you. E is for endocrine problems. Diabetes, we are living in a diabetic capital of the world. Every other person can be a diabetic or probable possibility of diabetes in him or her, as well as thyroid, which is a common disease with the ladies. Check your thyroid at least once or twice in a year, even when you're normal. So if E is endocrine and E is for exercise, without exercise, you will have an issues with your body stature, as well as your stress levels are going to go increase. Finally, N is no need to worry. Take my words, your doctor is there to help you out. Make sure you reach to him before it is too late. If you remember this mnemonic of women, make sure your women of your family is healthy, because the health and the wealth of the family depends on the woman, whether she is happy and she is healthy or not. We will come back with you another episode of Health Talk with another important and interesting topic. Today we thank Dr. Manjula for having joined us here, and we'll get back to you with another topic. Make sure keep watching our show. Stay happy, stay healthy, and stay blessed. May God bless you.